Field Ecology is a trip where we learn about adapting to new environments and new challenges that we had to face daily on the trip and will continue to face in our lives. It is a 9-day excursion to Sapelo Island in the Appalachians. We took this trip so we could study the environments and find correlations between different places. In these different places, we studied a certain area in depth, and we learned about the living and non-living things to figure out how environments functioned. This helped us grasp an understanding of ecology and, in general, what's going on in the world around us. During this trimester, each student received a job, which they carried out through the trip and during their site studies. These jobs were digital data collector, human impact, data analyst, cartographer, botanist, meteorologist, chemist, zoologist, and geologist. We asked our fellow colleagues about how the site studies here in St. Louis helped them prepare for the trip. We talked to Lauren, a zoologist, about how she prepared for the trip.
I got really comfortable with the equipment. I learned how to use the different nets and what each net is best for. So when I got on the big trip on the island and in the mountains, I was comfortable with the equipment so I could focus on what I'm catching and classifying the animals.
We talked to Victoria and Owen, some chemists, to see how they prepared for the trip.
The site studies before the trip helped the chemists learn how to actually do their jobs, rather than just bumbling around putting chemicals in the test tubes.
The site studies that we did before Field Ecology helped us chemists to practice and get used to doing the tests. That way, when we were on Sapelo Island for the first site study, we already had a pretty good grasp on what we were doing.
And lastly, we talked to Zach, one of the two geologists on the trip.
So the site studies before the trip were pretty much the only reason I knew what I was doing. Otherwise, I would have been very lost in all of the steps to identify the rocks and do the scratch tests and, well, for one, just how to use the hammer. Using the knowledge I took from the tests beforehand was very essential in the results I got in the field.
After three site studies and countless days of preparing, we finally got on the bus and left school for the incredible trip ahead of us. Our first stop was the Tennessee Aquarium in Memphis.
After dinner, we said goodbye to Memphis and drove a couple more hours to Hard Labor State Park in Georgia, where we would spend the night in order to rest up and prepare for the next day of our trip. The next morning, we continued our journey south to the ferry docks of mainland Georgia to catch a 15-minute ferry to the island of Sapelo. Once we arrived at the Sapelo Island docks, we were welcomed by the people and the island's sea life. We unpacked the boat and loaded the fun bus, which took us and our gear to our campsite, where we would spend the next three nights of our trip. The first site study was of the salt marsh in Sapelo.
I'm a geologist. There are no rocks here whatsoever.
But no, no, no. Keep it on tight so you can follow him just doing that.
I think got it. I think got it.
Oh my gosh, you got one.
What have you done so far today?
We have looked through the salt marsh, which is very muddy, and we looked for some mussels, which we are going to actually eat tonight.
Have you noticed any human impact around here?
Yeah, one of the other qualitative researchers and I, we were in the swamp or the marsh, and we found a piece of plastic about that big.
Okay.
In the mud.
My name's Nate, and I am a botanist.
He's here.
Okay, first, what plants have you seen?
So a lot of picklewort, some black needle rush, and a lot of cedar trees. And there's another tree over there we have yet to identify. The picklewort was really cool. It's edible and it tastes like the ocean, because when the tidal waves, if the tide moves or whatever, come back up here, the salt transfers to the pickleweed.
After the salt marsh site study, we had a snack back at the camp and headed to the ocean to catch some fish and do another site study. We headed to the camp to get rested up for the adventures that the next day held. The next day, we went to the wet lab and worked with a marine biologist. We caught phytoplankton and grass shrimp, which was a ton of fun.
We had a ton of fun working at the wet lab, but when we got back, we also got to go to the ocean again, this time for a super site study.
We asked Gray, a botanist, what a super site study was.
A super site study is a bigger version of a regular site study. The super site study was focused mainly on botany, and the botanists took control of the site study.
After the super site study, we had some fun back at camp because it was our last night at Sapelo.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we are about to conduct the super hardcore patty cake challenge between K3 and Owen St. Germain. This fight will begin in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Shelly, I need to sit down.
Come on, Owen!
Yeah. Owen wins!
And the winner is... Owen St. Germain!
The next day, we packed up and headed to Okefenokee Swamp, and on the way, we asked our classmates to reflect on our experience on Sapelo.
What I loved about Sapelo was how pretty it was. There was just a lot of beauty on the island.
One of the things I enjoyed most about Sapelo Island was the salt marsh. We got the experience to get dirty, learn about the things that lived in the salt marsh, and all while having fun.
I enjoyed Sapelo Island because it was really fun to be at the beach with all your friends and to learn a lot about the environment, which I wouldn't learn about if I was just there with my family. And it was also really fun to see more bigger diversity of animals versus just the non-saltwater places that we were at before.
At Sapelo Island, I believe there was much more natural diversity since there was a lot more animal life and plant life there.
Because of the government shutdown, we were not permitted to enter Okefenokee Swamp, but we still got to camp outside the normal campsite just outside the park.
We took one day to drive to the Nantahala Outdoor Center, and the next day we went whitewater rafting.
Crazy?
The next day, we did our site studies in the Smokey Mountains. We did the first one at the base of the mountains.
Hello, I'm here today in Wesser Creek in the Smokey Mountains area, and it is October 8th, Tuesday. And today it will be partly cloudy with a high in the mid-60s. Nathan, my friend Nathan's going to tell you about the weather tonight.
Tonight, the lows will be in the mid-40s.
I'm Keller, I'm a geologist. I'm looking forward to finding all the rocks and seeing the patterns in the volcanic activity in the area.
My name is William. I am currently a soil chemist. And I'm really looking for a clean soil that has the possibility of lots of plant life.
At this creek, I discovered that the proximity of the Nantahala Outdoor Center was beneficial to the creek because most of the people who stay at the Outdoor Center and who travel along this path are very serious hikers and know not to leave much human impact. We only found a battery and a few pieces of plastic, which is really good compared to the other sites we've been to.
My name is Victoria. I'm a water chemist, and something that I've noticed so far is that the turbidity of the water is very good. It's not cloudy at all. It's very clear. And so I'm expecting for botany or zoology to find a lot of water life, especially with the plants and the mosses that live at the bottom of the creek, because with the turbidity being so low, it allows sunlight to filter through and makes it easier for plants to live at the bottom.
My name's Nate. I'm a botanist, and the plant I am most excited to see
is a devil's walking stick because it was one of my adaptations and it has these really cool thorns lining it, and it's really cool.
After that site study, we took a long and treacherous hike up the mountain. When we got to the start of the creek, we did a mini site study.
Today was our last day. We drove back to St. Louis, which took about 10 hours, but we were too tired and lazy because we had to wake up at 5 a.m., so we didn't take any pictures at all. So, day 9.
Once we got back, we asked our classmates to reflect on the trip and what they thought of it as a whole.
Overall, I had a really good time on the trip. I learned a lot about being a qualitative researcher. Doing my job, I had to take lots of notes and record human impact, and I had a lot of fun while doing it. And I really liked being out in the field, going to the Smokies and Sapelo Island, and studying and researching there was really fun, and I had a great time.
On Field Eco, I had a really good time being cartographer, in that I learned that everywhere we went, the measurements and like everything about the area was different. Like from the Weser Creek in the mountains to the Cabretta Beach on Sapelo, the measurements were very different. I had a really good time doing it.
I had a really good experience on the Field Ecology trip. Being a meteorologist, I learned so much about weather that I had no clue that even existed. And I realized that the weather and things in meteorology really affects everything in the field. It affects biology, which are plants. It affects zoology, the animals. It even affects qualitative researching because that's human impact, and it can affect that in ways. So the trip was a really enjoyable experience for me because I feel like I learned a lot and also had a great time.
Overall, the trip was amazing. We learned a little bit about ourselves and one another while building a strong love for ecology. I think all of us would love to do the trip again.